This is the Aladdin Pipe Genie. This is not actually commercially available for sale just yet. This is a prototype kit which has been sent out to me to test. This is comparable in price to a pipe freezing kit, but it has considerable advantages over a pipe freezing kit. This kit contains four valves which can be used on 15mm pipe and also four valves that can be used on 22mm pipe. I do believe you can also get an imperial set which has four half inch and four 3/4 inch valves in that set. You get the spanner or the wrench. You then get a 15mm cutting tool and a 22mm cutting tool. You then get two 15mm bungs and two 22mm bungs. You then got the socket to drive it in, and you also get two small containers full of grease and a hex screwdriver for undoing the grub screw on these. And you also get a spur worm screw and a couple of spur grub screws. So this kit contains everything you need, however you will need a powerful cordless drill. I do have to point out that this is the prototype kit, so the actual kits that become commercially available may have some different components to these in it. This kit is going to be about £500 plus VAT when it does become commercially available. That is comparable to a professional pipe freezing kit, but this has a lot of advantages. For one, if you actually install one of these on the pipe and put the bung tool in, you can actually leave it for long periods of time, so you're not racing against a clock. You can quite comfortably leave it for an hour or longer once you've installed a valve. Another advantage of this kit is that you can actually use it on hot water, and you can also use it on flowing water, which is something that you can't do with a pipe freezing kit. This kit will also work on pressures up to 10 bar. Obviously this is very difficult to demonstrate in a real life situation, but I can do it using this setup. As you can see, we've got just over 8 bar of pressure in there. We do have a tiny leak on this system, so the pressure is dropping gradually. The actual mains pressure at this property is 8 bar, that's why I'm going to keep the needle above 8 bar whilst we do the test. I'm going to start off by taking the valve, ensuring that it is in the open position or pointing to the red dot. I'm then going to remove the pressure plate from the back and the nut. I'm then going to take that and slide that over the pipe. I'm then going to insert the pressure plate, and then I'm going to screw on the nut. When you do this, you do have to ensure that you don't cross-thread it. Now we've got that started, I can rotate that round to the correct orientation. This is a bit difficult because there's only just enough room to actually rotate that, and it is actually digging into the wood. But that would be easier if you had a longer piece of pipe because it would flex more. So I'm just going to hold that using a pair of water pump pliers whilst I tighten the nut. So that's the valve installed. You can actually install these on copper or plastic pipe. I'm now going to take the cutter tool. I'm just going to take some of the grease which is supplied with the kit. I'm just going to grease the worm screw at the end. Now we've done that, we need to unscrew the handle fully. We can then remove this cap. You now need to check that the valve is in the open position so that the slot is pointing to the red dot. If you take a look in the fitting, you can actually see that we've got a hole all the way through to the pipe. I'm now going to take the cutter tool and I'm going to screw that onto the valve. I'm now going to wind the handle in a bit. I've actually stopped there, there's some resistance there. We're now going to take the drill and the socket, ensuring it is in a forwards gear. Then I'm going to put that onto the nut at the end there. I'm going to start driving that, and I'm actually going to turn the handle at the same time. I can actually feel that that went all the way through. You will notice that we've lost a bit of pressure there, so I'm just going to pump that back up. I'm now going to undo that to remove the cutter and the slug. We've now lost even more pressure, so I'm just going to pump that up again. I'm now going to close the valve by turning it till it touches the green position. Now that we've done that, we've now closed the ball valve in there. We can now undo the cutter part. There will be some water that leaks out, obviously, when we do this. As you can see, there's minimal water there. If you take a look in there, you can actually see the copper coupon that has been cut out. We can now take the 15mm bung tool and we can screw that onto the valve. Once we've done that, we can then open the valve. We have actually lost a bit more pressure, so I'm just going to pump that up till we get back over 8 bar. I'm now going to screw in the handle on the bung tool. You can see that is actually increasing the pressure on the dowel there. We've now got the bung tool installed and that has created a stop in that pipe which would allow you to work on something on this side of the pipe work. So if you ever get a pipe that you can't freeze and it's got flowing water in it or hot water, this is the ideal solution. Just to prove that the bung's worked, I'm now going to open this valve. The pressure should stay the same in there, but we should lose the water that is trapped in there. And remember that is at least 8 bar of pressure. You can see that the dowel's not moving at all there, so the Pipe Genie has successfully trapped all the pressure in that part of the system, which would allow you to work on that part of the system. Once you've finished doing your work, you can simply unscrew the bung tool. Obviously the pressure is going to drop now because the water can get back up into this part of the pipe. So I'm going to unscrew that until it stops. I'll now just pressurise that to 8 bar again. I'm then going to close the ball valve. I can then unscrew the bung tool. And then finally we can replace the cap. You can of course buy the valves separately. This is just a prototype kit which has been sent out for me to test and I have to say that it has worked well. If you want to get one of these, you can actually pre-order them via Kickstarter. The company that's making these actually needs quite a bit of money to develop the product further before it actually goes into production. I will put a link in the description to the Kickstarter page. I think that's an absolutely fantastic idea, and once it has been developed fully, I'm sure that this will be a very common piece of kit for professional plumbers. I'd like to thank you for watching this video. If you've not done so already, please subscribe to the channel.